kept in by Andre Kostitsyn. Now Markov, cross ice, shot by Cavallari, he scores! Mike Cavallari, who hadn't scored a goal since coming back from an injury, scores here in the playoffs, his seventh career playoff. By Matt Bradley, deflects out, missed by Melanger. Joe Corvo with a wrist toward the net, he scores! Looks like an innocent little flip shot. And a lock for screen that may have been tipped in front, but the Caps have tied it at one.
Oh, the best kind of shot in that kind of situation with bodies in front is on net. It doesn't matter how hard. It really doesn't matter where sometimes. On net. But Chimera pushes the play down low. It forces the puck back into the high area where Corvo gets it. And there's three guys, if not four, in front. They line up in perfect formation, except that Halak can't see it. Chimera comes off the corner.
Pouliot stopped and kept in by Carlson. Loose puck and a chance. Score! Nick Backstrom! Canadians failed to clear. Backstrom found the puck in the slot and gives Washington a 2-1 lead.
He came into this season wanting to be more of a shooter and a scorer, and he accomplished that. If the puck didn't get out, the Lexus goal cam is going to show you where he tickets this one. Up over the...
A little more trouble getting up the ice. Gomez with a good move through the neutral zone. Here's Gianta. Pass it, front, score! Scott Gomez! A brilliant rush up the ice. Gomez started it, and Gomez finished it. Goal was matched by Scott Gomez. Brought in by Plekanec for a shot. He scores! Thomas Plekanec wins it for Montreal!
What a shot. This is the type of move that Alex Ovechkin's been dying to do all night long. Never accomplished it, at least getting one on net. Plekanec, who led the Canadiens in points during the regular season, sizzles one by Jose Theodore.
Gomez picks up the loose puck, drops it off to Gianta for a shot. He scores! Brian Gianta at the 1 minute mark gives Montreal a 1-0 lead.
This is either a knuckleball.
Stolen away by Kostitsyn. He moves it with a shot. He scores! Andre Kostitsyn makes it 2-0. Montreal has had only two shots on goal, and both have gone in. What does Bruce Boudreau do now?
Well, I think he first of all talks to his team about being smarter with the puck. Second of all,
pass goes by Kostitsyn. Here's a break. Eric Fair breaking in. He shoots. He scores.
Scored in the last eight games of the regular season. Didn't score the other night in game one. Gets it going game two. Fleischmann's pass. Red line in, breakaway. Heads up the entire time. You've got...
Puck just going back and forth and nobody getting anything sustained.
Cavallari for Montreal. Puts it in front. They score! Andre Kostitsyn. Off a good feed from Mike Cavallari. Montreal with a 3-2. Washington found out the last game. That puck deflects in. A power play goal by the Montreal Canadiens. And they lead it 4-1.
Bodies in front of the net. This is a shot that is about
the series. Corvo with a shot that goes wide. Backstrom drives away, scores! A big answer on a great shot by Nicklas Backstrom.
The guy in front of the net was Mike Knuble. Halak right away argued with the official down low that he thought he was interfered with. He pointed for a good goal. Watch Knuble get his wide body to the front, sticks on the ice. And you could maybe argue that he bumped into him before that puck got there. This angle might show it better. This is a heavy shot. Knubel in there. Does he touch him? No. He gets...
Good keep in by John Carlson. He tries it, a save. Hold on. And it's hooked in. Alexander Ovechkin.
He gets the defender to go down, and it gives him lock and load time. Body's in front of the net. It's then muscled in by Ovechkin. He waits patiently. This is a 20-year-old kid, folks, who has ice in his veins. No panic in his game. When he gets it, he's ready. He lets it go, and then there, the puck somehow gets through the legs of the goaltender, Halak, just with a little bit of a nudge from Ovechkin, and this place is going bananas right now.
4-3. Ovechkin, shot blocked. Hammerlick with a good job. Ovechkin in front. Score! Nicklas Backstrom ties the game. Becoming the impact player.
But he's playing playoff hockey now. They're going north-south. They're getting rid of the stuff where they're trying to toe drag, and they're trying to back up. They're pressuring the play. Mike Knubel and Alexander Ovechkin get in on the forecheck. That takes the eyes of on the bodies of the Canadiens. He's going to here. He's pushing it. He's going right there. He pushes it to the front of the net.
The board's cleared out. Chance for a two-on-one for Montreal. Pakanets pass across. They score! The Canucks! What a play! And Thomas Plekanec with the finish, and Montreal regains the lead 5-4. Oh, a slashing call. Carlson shoots. He scores! Penalty call, John Carlson ties it at 5.
This kid is unbelievable. If you just, you know, you watch him, and if he doesn't make you smile, you're missing something. This is a kid who is playing World Juniors a few months ago. Getting what?
They've lost 6 consecutive overtime games on home ice, including game 1 of this series. That wins it! Nicklas Backstrom! With a huge hat-trick goal!
They're rocking the red and they're blowing the roof off the Rizin Center as the hats come cascading down. What a shot by Backstrom! Knubel's gonna push the puck through the neutral zone, and then the D-man backs up. Watch right here. Brody gets it. Here comes a little push by Knubel. And the D-man Hammerlick backing up. He corrals it through the legs of Hammerlick over the glove. Another upstairs goal on Yaroslav Halak. That is where the Caps have had their most success against them. An absolute sizzler of a shot. Capitals go home victorious in overtime since the first time. As you said, Sammy.
His first career playoff goal.
Boyd Gordon was a healthy scratch in game number 2, and he was upset about it. He practiced with purpose. He got himself back in the lineup, and he starts his play, and eventually he...
Him, White plays it back for Green. Green to White. Quick shot, score! 2-0 Washington.
It was a loud crowd in here. It's not so loud anymore.
And back of the line, Markov. Bergeron shoots. Rebound. Kostitsa went right by it. That hit Varlamov in the mask again.
What a shot by Bergeron. Fantastic.
Now Morrison drops. White shoots. Carlson. Rebound. Score. Eric Fair. 3-0 Washington.
Varlamov's in his crease right now, and he's trying to shake the cobwebs at. What a shot by Bergeron.
Comes Ovechkin. Three Canadians converged on him. Canoe plays it down for Backstrom, looking at foot. Ovechkin scores! Alexander Ovechkin, 4-0 Washington.
I don't care who the goalie is, you're not stopping this. And this is Mike Knuble making a great read, and Nicholas
gets it across the line. Roman Hamler, for Camilleri. Center pass for Taylor, shoots the last goal!
Excellent for the Montreal Canadiens. That's more like it. Gets back to the first period, Gordon. More precision with the puck. Tape to tape to tape. And then you go to work. Camilleri, Plekanec, one rebound opportunity. Sticks it to the back of the net. The flow goes with the Canadiens because they let their skill do the talking.
Now a steal by Bradley. Locks in and shoots. Price to save. Each hit is down again. Price to they score. Matt Bradley makes it 5-1 with 44 seconds to go.
This line's been very difficult for the Montreal Canadiens to handle. Chimera.
Ovechkin, in and shoots, goes! Alexander Ovechkin, 1-0 Washington.
Gord, when you take too many penalties, especially against an elite team, you just said, how many times can you tempt fate? Not too many.
Vincent, is it there for Metropolitan? Then Metropolitan, right to our table, and the baby scores!
That's nice. Mike Camilleri wins a draw, left-hander, and he beats Brendan Morrison clean. The Canadiens get the puck and beat to Glenn Metropolitan, who's got some time and space. Not good enough rotation by Mike Green, and Camilleri getting strong in the slot. He scored in game number one on the power play. Now he scores in a five-on-five situation in game four because of
Jarrett. Waits. Sends it back to Markov with time. Shoot!
Canadiens deserve all of this applause, and Bruce Boudreau knows it. The guys in red care more right now than the guys in white. They're making the right decisions. They're battling for their ice. They want the puck more. Brian Gionta, swinging with the big trees, takes the carom off the backboard and sticks it to the back of the net.
Mike now Hamlet reaching back toward Gordon, comes in shorthanded with Knuble. Gordon sends it in front. They score! Mike Knuble shorthanded. 2-2.
Oh, Roman Hamlet. Just don't know what he's thinking in this situation. You're in the last minute of the period. You've got all the momentum on your side. No need.
Bites off Gomez and steps it across the line. For Ovechkin, he shoots, scores! Alexander Ovechkin again!
Best burst we've seen from Semin all series long. And Alexander
for Bradley. Matt Bradley fights loose, works it from Backage, a rebound score! Jason Chimera! His first career playoff goal, and it's 4-2 Washington. And Carey Price, after the goal was scored,
he's gonna get
fired the puck into the cap celebration. Can't, right?
Icing. Oh, was it? You know what? My bad. I apologize. It was icing.
Empty net for Mike Knuble. Walks in and shoots, scores. Mike Knuble, empty net goal. 5-2 Washington now lead.
Good catch by you, Gord. That was icing. My apologies, and you're right. And for Jacques Martin, there's no three-goal comeback coming for them tonight.
The Washington Capitals have once again silenced this noisy crowd. In comes Gord. Dominic Gord. Back to a shot. Score! First career playoff goal for Dominic Moore. 5-3.
You live by the sword, and sometimes you die by the sword. For the Washington Capitals, it's all offense all the time, not a whole lot of shutdown ability. And in this situation, Dominic Moore goes coast to coast around Fleischman, around Tyler Schwartz, and around Joe Corvo, and up over the shoulder of Semyon Varlamov. He goes basically 200 feet to score this goal, Gord. Fleischman, nope. Sloan, nope. Corvo, nope. And the puck will kiss the back of the net after it goes up and over the shoulder of Varlamov.
At the line is Markov. Kicks it there for Gianta. And the puck loose for Pony to Ovechkin. And once again, sends it ahead. Backstrom shoots, scores. Nicklas Backstrom fires it home. It is now a 6-3 game. Backstrom with his fifth goal of the series. Andre Markov centers. Cavallari scores! Mike Cavallari fires it home, and Montreal leads 1-0.
What a pass by Andre Markov. This is something else by Markov. He makes a...
Jumping up is Hal Gill. Plays it down to Gianta centering. Pass knocked down. Malone scores! Travis Malone, 2-0 Montreal.
I know everybody in Montreal wants to rip the coach apart. This is a coaching adjustment. We've talked about it since the opening faceoff. Travis Mullen is making a difference.
Fresh legs on the ice for the Caps. Ovechkin tries to knock that in front. Spins away from Harrell. Peels back again. Back he goes to Carlson. Carlson feeds it in front. That goes wide. Ovechkin back to Carlson. Wise and fires. Deflected puck. Lucid for the score.
John Carlson makes it happen. He finds a way to take that Ovechkin pass and get it around Metropolitan first, and then Ovechkin again gets it back. Metropolitan sprawls out, and he gets that puck through, and eventually Kanuba backs away, and Ovechkin snaps it home.
Bergeron, the shot blocked. Bergeron chased the puck, and they score!
It in that perfect spot. Varlamov looking, finds it. He's square. That's just the most physical we have seen from the Canadians for a sustained amount of time in this series, Sam. That kind of physical presence right there, that's what you need out of a big D-man.
Subban playing it, and they score! Cavallari got it through again!
Mike Camilleri is going to come across, open, and just shoot. That's a bad goal that Varlamov gives up there. The Washington Capitals knew that this was...
Bad. There's a chance for Ovechkin stopped by Halak. The knuckleball. Here's Maxime Lapierre with a drive. He scores! It's 3-0 Montreal.
LaPierre's first point of the playoff. Smokes it by Semyon Varlamov. Beats him up top. I mean, this is just a wicked shot. It might have just gone off the stick.
5 to go. Third period. Pass through. Green shoots. Score! Eric Fair with a deflection in front, and they break Halak's stranglehold. It's a 3-1 game as they finally break through on the 52nd shot on goal. Able to move it to Kostitsyn, out of the zone. Here's Cavallari. Empty net. Kostitsyn scores! Here, 4-on-3 power play for Montreal for 40 seconds. Markov with it. Gomez. Giantis in front. Gomez to Bergeron. He scores! A power play goal for the Montreal Canadiens. Gives them a 1-0 lead.
with just over 29 seconds remaining in the period.
Marc-Andre Bourque.
LaPierre against Green. Green missed it. Moore shoots. He scores! Dominic Moore gives Montreal a 2-0 lead with 3:36 to go.
This play starts by the veteran defenseman Hal Gill, a so-called one-dimensional type of guy, making just the
forwards on. Ovechkin's playing back at the point. Here's Backstrom. Shot by Like, saved, the rebound clear to side. Ovechkin there, backhander block. They score! Brooks Like on the rebound. Washington is still alive.
A rebound by Halak into a high traffic area helped create this goal, and then it is the dive on the backhand right there, the spin move and the backhand shovel by Brooks Like that makes this a one-goal deficit for the Caps right now. A simple play of throwing it to the net, of creating a rebound opportunity.
And gets a return pass from Kimmo Tiiminen. Down low, Richard sends it across. Brodeur down scores! A power play goal, and Philadelphia strikes first.
As this play was developing to the left of Marty Brodeur, Chris Pronger took off from the blue line and ended up parking himself on the goal.
Mike Richards a blast, and it's 2-0 Flyers.
This is an excellent shot by Richards, but Brodeur overplayed this. It's right in my sight line, and he went from his left to his right, and he overcommitted about a half a foot to his blocker side, and Mike Richards ripped it to the glove side. There's a lot of room over on Brodeur's glove side that Richards is able to find. The Richards shot deflects off of Brodeur's pad and goes up into the top of the net. The Devils haven't turned the puck over very much at all. They turn it over there, and Mike has been very, very quiet tonight.
Here's Green in deep, back. It goes, Zajac bounces, scores! Not anymore! And a lucky bounce has New Jersey back in it.
Well, I just finished saying Zajac has been so quiet. He had barely mentioned his name tonight, Chris. The Flyers got a break on Pronger's goal and bounced in off Ralston. This play starts with Andy Green, who's down on the forecheck. This puck hits Ian LaPerriere wandering through the slot. LaPerriere's trying to get in the way. He ends up...
He'll hold now Matt Carl, and Carl missed it. Patrick Elias away. Parise dancing. He's got a break. Zach Parise scores! Shorthanded. Parise. New Jersey leads.
What finish, but what a fabulous pass by Patrick Elias. As soon as this puck turned over, watch Zach Parise. He's in the middle of the ice. He takes off. There's no chance Chris Pronger can catch him. And this is a gorgeous feed from Patrick Elias. They're at a standstill in the middle of the ice, and the explosive Parise gets into the clear, and this is a gorgeous finish.
Seven playoff games, all one-goal games. Couple of overtime markers, and now Giroux in front scores! Aaron Atcham, the former Devil, and it's tied at one!
Great patience by Claude Giroux going around the back of the net, and Aaron Atcham, who had 10 goals this year.
Gagne across, back in front off a skate, Carl steps up, hit shot, score! Redirect in front, and Giroux's got it! It's a 2-1 Flyer lead. Oh, Devils pressure, looking for the tying goal. Colin White again, shot, scores! Drew Boucher, and time. Never mind Ilya Kovalchuk or Patrick Elias or Jamie Langenbrenner. It's Colin White. This is 101 games in the making. A wrist shot that squeaks through Boucher. This is the first crack for Brian Boucher in the series. It trickles through his legs. Colin White's second playoff goal has tied the game at two.
And Ray, he was well away. Ilyash has the puck. Drops it back. Kovalchuk. Ilyash into the slot. What a goal! What a goal! Andy Green! Tic-tac power play goal!
Directing traffic. He's pointing that he's going to come through the middle of the slot. This is a beautiful pass from Elias. The deflection has to be perfect because Green is so far from the net. Kovalchuk to Elias. There's no way Boucher is going to stop it. That looks like one of those deflections that Daniel Sedin puts away from his brother Henrik in Vancouver.
4-on-3, Flyers deliberate score! Teaming it through that big screen! And I'm not sure Pronger got a tip or not.
Tie game. That shot went clean through. Brodeur is wrestling around with Chris Pronger in front of the net. I mean, it's like standing behind the Empire State Building. You can't see a thing. Against the third Philly pair.
Well, Zuber's being held up. Zuber's in front of backhand. Sun scores!
Work by Elias, Zubras, and Parise. They've got the Flyers running all over the place. Oscar Bartulis is skating around. He's got nobody covered. Look at the strength of Zubras. He pushes Parent aside, makes a nifty move to the front, and Zach Parise's second of the night.
Played by Skula, deep for Hartnell. Salvador watching him. Out it comes, Carter fans.
Oh, his stick's broken. He can't play the puck.
Kovalchuk, empty net. Kovalchuk scores! The finishing touches on the first ever Stanley Cup playoff win for Ilya Kovalchuk.
To Ralston. And now Ralston tees it up, scores! Ralston opens the scoring on a power play goal. 1-0 New Jersey.
They spread them out. They get LaPerriere down. And then they just shoot it right through the screen. Brian Ruff.
Back he goes to Pronger. Across the team.
Rolling for the score.
Giroux's skill level is incredible, but what a pass by Kimmo Tiivanen, and he takes the relay from Pronger. Mike Richards taking up space. That creates a backdoor seam. No stick on the ice for the Devils defender right there, Colin White. What a pass by Tiivanen, stick on the ice for Claude Giroux. 1-1 after a bad penalty.
Pronger with it. Pronger got smacked there by Ilya Kovalchuk. Another puck stolen, loose in front, score!
Everybody wants to hit. The puck stays alive. Chris Pronger takes a hit from Kovalchuk to keep the play alive.
That's what you think you have to do. There's a no glove on Mark Fraser. He gets hit. He loses a puck. Carcillo takes it in, puts it out front. Mike Richards capitalizes. All because of good board play and hard board play. Simon Gagné hard, Dan Carcillo hard, and then the hard score!
Brian Ralston again, and it's 2-2.
I don't know if this touches somebody or not. Brian Ralston's got a vicious shot. We saw that in the first period on the power play goal. And on Brian Boucher, I think this might have changed directions because the puck wasn't...
Plays it up the side of the net. Carcillo waves it from Philadelphia.
Face-off win for the Philadelphia Flyers. Mike Richards wins it back. Then they can go to work. Carcillo in a joust with Colin White. But they keep the play alive. It's a good job of board play. Mike Richards tries to score from behind the icy line. Brodeur can't track the puck board, so it comes straight across to Danny Carcillo. Brodeur thinks he's got it wrapped up. He doesn't. It goes right to the stick of Carcillo, and he's got the overtime magic. Board work by Simon Gagné, Mike Richards, and a finish by Dan Carcillo.
But now he's out of the play as Kovalchuk moves to the slot. Shot star, Ilya Kovalchuk. Into full celebration mode as he ends his frustration for now with a 5-on-3 goal, and it's 1-0 New Jersey.
Well, we've talked this entire series about how the Flyers have tried to take away Ilya Kovalchuk's time, take away his space. That's an impossibility.
To the point, teaming it. Now Briere, Hartnell is in front, taking the punishment, now rotating to the slot. There's pass for Carter. Carter to the slot, his shot, he scores! Kovalchuk on the board, now Carter is on the board, a power play goal, the Flyers tie this game in one. Carter scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
Time and space for Jeff Carter, and laser-like precision with this shot. One of the best wrist shots in the world.
Revving it up to center ice is Braden Coburn. To Briere, he'll wind, fire, and score! Danny Briere is now on the board as he rips one past Brodeur. And for the first time tonight, the Flyers have the lead. Briere scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
What a rocket. What a rocket by Danny Briere. This baby had a vapor trail behind it. And as quick as Marty Brodeur's glove has been in this game, it wasn't fast enough to get to that one.
Carl to Pronger, a shot goes wide. Colin White swung to Pond and Carcillo. Picks it up, angle shot, he scores! Dan Carcillo is the hero again! And the Flyers now lead 3-1, their first third period goal of the series. Carcillo scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
This is something the Flyers wanted to do early in the series, but they really haven't gotten around to it, and that is just get pucks low from sharp angles at Marty Brodeur's feet. Brodeur ended up with his helmet ripped off, but I think it was his own player, Mike Motto, that caught him from behind, and Dan Carcillo
touches his heart and gets to it. Now it is Carr with a shot off the glove of Brodeur, and then up over the net and drops onto the mesh on the other side. Off the draw, Flyers with it. Pronger to Timonen. Time to set up one play with a 5-on-3. Briere to Pronger, the blast! Save, and it squeaks through, and they score! Brodeur got a piece. It may have been tipped home in front. As Jeff Carter was in the vicinity, and the power play goal makes it 4-1 Philadelphia.
It's over the line. He hooked up.
Centering pass scores! What a quick pass that was! And Briere's got the goal, and the Flyers have the icebreaker.
This is highly skilled work by both Claude Giroux and...
Away goes Richards. Mike Richards with the shot blocked, rebound put in front. Here's the chance, Giroux! Off the post, is it in? Yes! 2-0 Flyers, or is it in? No word yet, the Flyers celebrate, and they're gonna have to confer the two officials, and we're being told downstairs that puck did go in. Brodeur high stick side, and it's 2-0. Now Briere, the other goal scorer, with the shot. Hartnell, the doorstep, scores! Just like that, Giroux has another! And it's 3-0 Philadelphia.
Pretty simple approach here for the Devils. Point shot, rebound, traffic. Claude Giroux is second of the period, and it's 3-0.
The zone. Back to the point, broken up, and away goes Roy. Roy darting in over the line. Here's Roy. Dropped it back down and scores!
With a shot that looks like it had radar on it, and it missed the goal post and missed the goalie, and you know the result.
Well, Buffalo draws first blood in the opening game of this. Fires it across ice. Another shot. Miller made the same rebound. They score. Recchi. And the Bruins have tied it up on the power play.
You know how many times we've said, get the point shot through on the power play. Good things happen. Recchi, the most experienced playoff player on either team, ties the hockey.
Line and over is Kennedy, who slides it over to the side. Rive shoots one. Score!
Ray, that's more than a goal to put Buffalo ahead. After being badly outplayed in the second period, they score to go ahead with 5 minutes left.
They had an awful lot of trouble in their own end, but
cleared it in front of the net, and Vanek couldn't get a stick on it. Vanek tapping it back to the point. Talinder off to Myers again. He'll let it go. That deflects his goal! Tyler Myers ripped the shot from the point, and Buffalo has the 1-0 lead.
Well, it was deflected, but I'm pretty sure it was deflected by a Boston Bruin defender. And Buffalo get one thing.
Knocked it to Montador, who got it up on the wing and out to center. Ellis works it to Coletta. Coletta slipping it in over the line. Backhand, they score! The pride of Roland, Matt Ellis, comes it home, and Buffalo has a 2-0 lead.
Well, I mentioned the speed of the Buffalo team, especially among their forwards, and secondary scoring has been one of Buffalo's strength coming down the stretch, and here's another example of it as Ellis will cash in on a backhander on the long.
Wheeler dumped it in front. They shot by Swoboda, and Miller made the save. The rebound, they score! That jumped up in the air after Miller got a piece of it, trickled over the goal line, and Boston is now trailing by one.
A prolonged offensive zone forecheck and puck recovery by Boston led to the chance and eventually the goal.
But lost control of it. Boston keeping it in again. Back to the point. That shot deflects. Here's the rebound. They score. Chara moves up to jam it home. And Boston is tied in at two. Spun back to center ice again, chasing after it. Pominville. He gets in over the line and runs over Weidman. Came in front. Pominville scores! Tyler Ennis with a perfect pass finds Pominville, and he rips it home, 3-2 Buffalo.
Well, some good forechecking by Buffalo. They came up with a loose puck, and Ennis makes a pass right onto the tape for Pominville, and Pominville knows where the net is and proved it on that.
Start away again. In comes Ryder getting it across. Ace, the repass from front. They score. Ryder gobbling up the loose puck and tapping it in, and it's tied at three.
Buffalo created a 4-on-2 rush for Boston and some two good passes, Ryder being on the recipient of the third one and put it in. And we got a tie game with 14:37 to go in the third period.
Krejci gets checked at the blue line, then carries on after it again and gets knocked down in the corner. Finally taken away, but not out. Chara keeping it in. He scores! Chara took the shot from the point. I don't know if it deflected or not, but the Bruins have their first lead of the game. Goodman slapped at it. Can't get it. Here's a chance for the Bruins. Nothing but net. They score. And Boston will go on to win this one as Dan Poirier puts it away and makes it a 5-3.
Storm the drive and a save by Miller as he squeezes the knees. Ryder with Sobotka on his immediate left. Ryder looks across the zone to Wheeler. The shot saved by Miller. This has been a tremendously physical battle. Here's Greer with a chance. He scores! Mike Greer picks the glove side corner, and Buffalo, for the third time in the series, has drawn first blood.
Greer, close proximity, takes that feed. Now he's got inside.
Just hammered all over the ice. Back of the goal, it's Weidman shipping it out to Ryder. Hunwick with space, jumping up on the play with Sobotka. Hunwick drives the goal. Sobotka to Weidman, scores!
Advantage of Buffalo's moving forward defense, but Sakari just pointed out on the Sturm chance, he's trying to pinch again. When the wingers come low like Michael Ryder did, you have better opportunities to make plays.
Weidman leads out Bergeron. Bergeron gets it past Gostad with effort. Connolly, or rather Kennedy and Recky. Recky wins the battle of Bergeron. He scores!
So important. He's just trying to get to the red line here. He has the puck taken away from him, but what does he do? He stops on the puck. He doesn't turn away. He doesn't give up. He stays with it, gets the puck in.
There's Matt Ellis, who was on the receiving end of Boychuk's classic open ice hit in game three, was not able to dress for tonight's game. There is Cody McCormick. Tyler Ennis tosses it into McQuaid's corner. And we got a push. McCormick gets sandwiched. Here's a loose puck. Score! Opens the scoring for Buffalo. It was the guy who got knocked off the puck by Recky. A huge goal for the Sabres. For the drive tip, scores off Weidman's stick. It beats Rask on the glove side, and Buffalo has a 2-0 lead.
Here's the drive off of the shaft, and the power play out a little higher.
Hunwick shot, save, rebound, Krejci scores.
The blue line, almost like a third defenseman. It opens up more space down low. The Bruins go double barrel action right in front of Miller. It's like a power eye. Down low, right on top of Miller is Bergeron.
He one times it through both corners. Boychuk past Torres, collides with Ludman. Paye, Bergeron knocks it down, wheel shoots, scores!
About this shift, it all centers around Patrice Bergeron. He stays with the play along the boards after some great work by Paye. Good pitch down the wall. Boychuk gets position, keeps the play alive, goes through his man. The backhand feed from Paye finds Bergeron. Transfer the puck side to side, and then wheel the puck. They had a couple opportunities with some redirects.
Ryder steps around Greer. Ryder to Chatan. He scores! Miroslav Chatan, a golden goal. The Bruins win the game and lead the series 3-1.
Tip back in along the board, came in front of the net. Kirby chopped it in behind the goal. There scores! And a
Adam Mayer from behind the net on a bit of a wraparound. Puts the Sabres in front on a goal that Tuukka Rask should have had.
Zone. Cleared ahead to the line. Emma stole it back. Got it to Roy. Took a shot right on the rebound. He scores! Jason Pominville picks up the rebound, taps it home, and Buffalo has built the lead to 2-0.
It looked like the Bruins were out of trouble.
Didn't waste any time. They were throwing at the net, and guys going.
Quick shot by Greer. He scores!
Second goal of this playoff from the top of the circle on a cleanly won faceoff by Gostad, and Greer put it off the post and in. There's no way that Boston could get their defenders out when the draw is won that cleanly. And Greer made no mistake on this.
Chetan back to the point. Over to Boychuk. He scores. Boychuk with a rocket inside the post, and a power play goal has put Bruins on the board.
2:30 to go on the 18th shot of this period by Boston. Boychuk from about 45 feet out.
Front of the net, taken back again by Pominville, and he just eases it down the ice, and here's Ennis slapping it, and he scores!
Picks up his second point of the game and his fourth point of the series. And he has been a real shot in the arm to Buffalo. And with a diving poke check, he puts this game.
Krejci, Hunwick, and Chara, the unit for the Bruins on the power play now. Derek Roy defends against Wick. The redirection scores! First block, first time in the series. The Bruins lead the Sabres 1-0.
Create the two-on-one high, and now look for your plays. It forces Buffalo to have to be a little bit more stationary. And now
Krejci, top of the circle now. It's Bergeron to Krejci. The slap to Recchi. He scores! 2-0 Bruins. Both power play goals.
Well, the Bruins really had a four-man box formation for a lot of this four-on-three with nobody in front of the net. But the little bit of adjustment that Dennis Wiedemann's going to make on this goal by attacking the net right through opens up just enough space. It shifts the triangle.
And Mayer knocks down the clearing attempt, closes toward goal. Kennedy, the shot scores on the deflection. Patrick Kaleta gets Buffalo on the board. A costly turnover right into the legs of Adam Mayer, and the Sabres have rolls the puck in deep. Lucic for Krejci scores! David Krejci off Milan Lucic's win of the battle back of the goal. The Bruins lead by two.
Their top offensive guys, Roy, Pominville, and Vanek, Myers to Linder. The Bruins doing a terrific job. Milan Lucic, I mean, this is just simple hockey. The wrap.
Desperate. McQuaid, deafening din. Here's a giveaway, a score! Nathan Gerby answers! A tremendous answering rush by the Buffalo Sabres, and it was a two-goal lead for only 22 seconds. Right back, blows a tire. Here comes Chetan, he deeps, he shoots, and Miller robs him! What an unbelievable save from Ryan Miller! Hunwick up the boards for Chetan. Saucers it over to Wiedemann. Wiedemann throws it through the middle. Chetan scores! Miro the hero! It's 4-2 Bruins!
You gotta keep making plays coming out of your own zone, and the Bruins do. And it leads to a couple opportunities up ice. Great pressure by Krejci. Now Chetan has an opportunity. Somehow Ryan Miller with his athleticism able to get a piece of that move to the forehand by Shatan. And Dennis Watt.
20 seconds to go. Tony Ludman indirect up to the line to Jason Pominville. Pominville throws it across the back. He scores! 1:13 to go, and Buffalo refuses to go quietly into the night.
Struggled earlier in the season, but they recovered to finish 19th overall. Gonchar, the master up top, holding on to it. Gonchar looks it over. One-timer, Malkin scores! Short-side goal for Evgeny Malkin, and Pittsburgh is off and running.
He is the master. Gonchar surveying, reading, delivering, Malkin.
Gonchar 55, watch for him.
Jason Spencer from well out, picked out by Fleury, and they score! Peter Regan picks up the rebound and ties it for Ottawa.
Easy to find Gonchar there.
Player of that caliber will get his chances as Fleury bodies that shot down, taken by Chris Phillips, and they score on the rebound! And a guy who has come through in the clutch all season for Ottawa, Chris Neal, gets it done, and the Sens have a 2-1 lead.
Faceoff win so important.
Kovalev on there, his puck handling skills great, puck retrieval skills not so much, so they're able to keep plays alive better, and that one is absolutely a dagger off the glass to the front of the net, and Ottawa gets the break on Fleury in a 3-1 lead.
Chris Kelly is the beneficiary of the odd carom. We'll see it right here in Ottawa. Crosby goes wide of Elliott. Up top it's Gonchar. On the wall, Malkin. He'll advance, shoot one, he scores! Evgeny Malkin breathes a little life into Pittsburgh. 3-2, Ottawa.
Reasons to cheer here again. Now we just showed you how they kill penalties. Well, that's all predicated.
Getting to it now is Mike Fisher. Ottawa's captain, Daniel Alfredson, one-timer. Cullen, locked in front, rebound, scores! Eric Karlsson, his first playoff goal. Ottawa back up by a deuce.
And Dan Bylsma knows that his goaltender is not tracking the puck. It went in.
Look at Sergei Gonchar. Orpik is finished off by Foligno. Talbot golfs it out for Dupuis. Coming up on Karkner. Craig Adams is in. On his backhand, he scores! Craig Adams, an unlikely hero for Pittsburgh, brings them within one.
He's not a hero yet, but certainly capping off start to this period.
Chris Neal's in with Jarkko Ruutu. Ruutu with a shot. He scores! He finds a hole and gets it done. And again, Ottawa answers. And they go back up by two.
They've taken advantage. But Pittsburgh did this to themselves. 1-4 right down the ice. Kennedy misses the net.
Down by Evgeny Malkin. Give it a bump by Volchenkov. And now Crosby again. Fancy pass. He scores! Kalinowski gets a beauty from Sidney Crosby, and the Pens won't go away. And team number one, Daniel Alfredson, Jason Spezza, Peter Regan. First shot, scores! Peter Regan! In his first game, his first goal, make it two, surprising Marc-Andre Fleury and the Pens.
We just showed you.
I talked to Corey Kluse. I said, so what'd you talk to your young goaltender about? He's an intense guy. And you know what? I talked to him maybe 2 minutes.
Chris Kunitz with a shot fought off and fought in. Crosby out in front. And Pittsburgh answers back.
Unfortunately for Elliott, he juggled that one as well.
Redding and starting on Jason Spezza. He puts on a show. Crosby out in front from his knees. Back for Letang. His shot scores! Chris Letang finds a way, and the Penguins are up by one.
By choosing that game.
Bonakarovsky pulls on the brakes, takes a shot, and scores! With only one goal in the previous 17 playoff games, Alexei Bonakarovsky gets Pittsburgh started.
And there's all kinds of people.
Pittsburgh will survive, as you see. Evgeny Malkin wheel it out. It rolls in front of Elliott, it's loose, they score! Evgeny Malkin gets it done! And Pittsburgh is up by one.
What a turn of events, because this is the
man. Bill Guerin wins the battle. Carry it out to center ice. Hook is out of the box, moving up on Karkner. And a jolt by Ottawa's Matt Karkner. Out of the corner, Crosby. Out in front, Sidney Crosby. Scoring! Another beauty for 87! And Pittsburgh has a 3-1 lead.
The details on goals.
Punches back for Kunitz. Ahead of the field, Billy Guerin's in. He's onside. Guerin deeks. He scores! Bill Guerin makes it 4-1, Pittsburgh.
Fantastic work in their own zone. Crosby and Kunitz. Guerin flies the zone and then almost.
Letang. Daniel Alfredson. Cross ice Cullen. They score! Matt Cullen surprises Marc-Andre Fleury. Ottawa down by two.
Everybody has something to cheer here. And don't go away quite yet, folks. It's just a two-goal game. You can see Fleury.
Sidney Crosby, Evgeny Malkin. Gonchar looks it over. One-timer Malkin. They score! A bullet by 71. Evgeny Malkin. And Pittsburgh has a one. Who has the puck from Gonchar. In is Crosby out of nowhere. He scores! Sidney Crosby makes it 2-0. Pittsburgh.
Defensive zone play, Jason Spezza.
9 scoring points in the playoffs. Third goal, 3:47 the time. Talbot, wide open, Cook, he scores! Matt Cook puts the defending champions in control. They lead 3-0.
To me, by and large, because they were able to get on the power play, and they ran their power play so well.
Crosby, room again, and he finds it. Sidney Crosby picks a corner. 4-0, Pittsburgh.
That'll end it for Elliott.
Paul Karkner, chopping one. Kelly settles it down for Campoli. Delaying, getting Cook to go down. Off sticks, it's loose. They score! Chris Neal! And then a hit, he'll take a penalty for that. But get the goal, and Ottawa's on the board.
Craziness. Place is going nuts. That was as scrambly a shift as you'll ever.
Fisher. Cullen again out in front. Centers off Fleury. Alfredson again. Looks for a lane. Throws it across for young Carlson. Alfredson's shot. Scores! A Swedish connection. Carlson to Alfredson. Ottawa down by two.
They have life now. Corey Kluse did not back.
Off the glove of Matt Cullen. He takes away the ice momentarily of Craig Adams, who now sneaks in. Centers one. They score! Craig Adams to Max Talbot. A huge goal. Pittsburgh back up by three. It's now Alfredson. Inside for Jason Spezza. Alfredson across for Carlson. Daniel Alfredson thinks about it. Two-man advantage for Ottawa. A chance, they score! Matt Cullen gets a great pass from Jason Spezza, and Ottawa is back in it.
All set up by the faceoff win by Cullen. It's appropriate he gets the goal. Well done, because they were really decisive.
Bill Guerin over the line, Crosby in front. The pass, knocked down, the rebound, scores! Chris Kunitz left all alone, and Pittsburgh has a 6-3 lead.
And this is why the Ottawa Senators don't want to have a track meet.
He'll wind it up. Obviously, plenty of room. Shot taken. He scores! He'll stay put on the power play. Ottawa's back. Hurry out to play it. Now it's cleared out to center ice. Jordan Staal. Staal lays it up for Goligoski. His shot punched out and punched in. Jordan Staal picks up the loose change after LeClaire spent out a rebound. 7-4 Penguins.
Yeah, that's the one.
So, orchestrating at the line away for Daniel Alfredson, along with Mike Fisher up front. All the way back for Erik Karlsson, the 19-year-old defenseman with a shot. Tipped in! Mike Fisher out in front. And Ottawa gets another power play goal. Exactly what they need.
If you could draw it up through Corey Kluson, this is how he, the bullet points he put out there started this hockey game.
Nick Foligno uses the back of the goal. Centers one. Forked in! Jarkko Ruutu out in front. Ottawa by two.
Stunning the crowd. Ruutu, they've just said, when we get into the offensive zone, put it in the paint.
Malkin again, one-timer fanned down by Guerin. Letang shot, scores! Chris Letang! It's the answer. The Penguins cut the lead in half.
After game one.
Top line reunited here by Dan Biles, but Crosby, Guerin, and Kunitz. Crosby, shot taken, good save, LeClaire. Rebound chance, stop, no goal. Ryan Pucmera waves it off. Kunitz thought he had it. The whistle had blown.
Net came off, I think, on the short side as they were chopping. Act of blowing the whistle. The boos will rain down. Fabulous push here late in the period by the Penguins. Kunitz is incensed. Oh, that's a tough one because I can see as a forward, you want that to be good. As a goaltender, you say, not a problem.
To clear, he will. Andy Sutton moves it along the boards. Alex Goligoski awaiting that puck. This way again for Gonchar. They'll stay patient with it. Gonchar looks it over, guarded by Kelly Arister. Score! The puck had eyes. And it's batted down with a high stick out in front and waved off by Dan O'Halloran.
They had patience on that power play. They got the look they wanted. Off of the stick of Chris Kunitz, I believe. Just a long range wrister.
This series, the two of us, along with Carissa, we've been gushing about this player, but it has just gone to another level. It's been incredible. And how about this? An incredible goal by Peter Regan. And yes, Ottawa has a breath. They've tied it at three.
It went from the Crosby story, Crosby on the bench. Everybody has to sit.
Carried in by Alfredson. He'll stop. Lay it back. Partner shooting one. Tip. They score! Tipped out in front. Matt Kartner from the point. Ottawa lives to fight another day.
General manager Brian Murray has to be.
Decides to back out to the neutral zone as Alfredson finds a man wide open. It's Cullen. He's in the clear. He scores. Matt Cullen makes it 1-0 Ottawa.
Chip and the quick breakout. Alfredson head up, catches Cullen tape to tape. There's the poke check.
Ruutu gonna win the battle for the puck. Back to the front of the net, off of Eaton. Chance for Kelly, stop, rebound. Neal scores. Chris Neal with his third goal of the series. And the Senators lead it 2-0.
And what about Ruutu? The play he made off the wall. I after the power play. Coming into the game with 27 hits in the series and a pair of goals. Look at Ruutu coming off the wall. Eaton tries to block it. He can't. He takes a penalty. A delayed.
Swept aside.
That's great stuff, Dan. I mean, you have to do that. And the Penguins also, you have to look out here.
Score. Alfredson. There is face-off win. Puck goes deep. Alfredson wins possession of that puck.
Behind by Kunitz on Volchenko. Hit the game in the bank. Centering pass. Dupuy goes to the net. It comes right back to Staal. Here's Orpik with it. Now to Gonchar. A shot. Rebound opportunity. Staal with a shot. Save. Score the rebound. I think Matt Cook is the last guy to get a stick on it. He was down on his knees. And the Pittsburgh Penguins have made it 3-1. That's a big goal. It was blocked. 11 seconds to go on the penalty. Goligoski fakes the shot. Guerin a drive. Score! Billy Guerin with a rising shot. Makes it 3-2. It's a power play goal.
And he ripped it over the glove hand. I'm saying shoot it on the ice, but I'm telling you, you ask a goaltender, it's not the same feeling when you got that stick in your hand as
Taper. Evgeny Malkin. Malkin closes in to Staal. His shot. Big save on Leclerc. Time Mario Lemieux. Here's a chance right in front. Cook. He scores. Matt Cook gets his second goal of the game to tie it at 3. And I think Crosby might get a point. They can move a little closer to that record.
Absolutely incredible. The big boy looks on, and Matt Cook goes to the front of the net with a bad angle shot off a faceoff. The Penguins go to the wall.
Sid won the draw.
And there it is. Just shoot the puck. Mark Eaton, that puck might have been touched on the way in. It was a Penguin who got his stick on that, possibly.
Position. Staal to Dupuy. He scores! Pascal Dupuy wins it for the Penguins, and they are going to the second round. Pascal Dupuy's first goal of this series is the overtime game winner.
And what a perfect shot by Pascal Dupuy. There was not much room where the crossbar and the goal post meet. And the Penguins come all the way back, and Jordan Staal.
Leading the rush, setting up at the circle. John Michael Lyles to the corner now. Stastny feeding a nice pass to Duchesne, to Lyles. His shot fires, scores! Lyles, rooftop shot on the power play, and the Avalanche have opened the scoring in San Jose.
You talk about simplifying the power
corner, trying to use his big frame to shield the puck, throws it towards the net, he scores!
Ryan Clough, this is how you score goals in the playoffs. Play with your back, play strong, have the defender on his hip pocket, good traffic by his teammates going to the net. Take a look at bringing John Michael Lyles along for the ride.
Corner, turning away from Vlasic. Gagliardi with 1 minute to go, tries to come in front, the net bouncing up and down off its moorings. Stewart behind the net, Stastny to Chris Stewart. In front, they score! Gagliardi on a deflection! The Avalanche have the lead. TJ Gagliardi, who has paid a price all night, stands in front.
And now it's in front, and they score!
Off of Mark Edward Vlasic's face.
And a minute 10 in, Colorado leads again with the first goal of the game.
We talked about ugly hockey, playoff hockey, you throw pucks to the wall.
Still on the power play, Boyle. Down behind the goal line, a chance at the side. Malhotra scores. Finally, a payoff for so much hard work on the power play. 1-1.
We'll be right back.
Sabres off a bad bounce, but here's a breakaway for Chris Stewart back the other way. Cuts in and scores. And what looked like was going to be a bad Colorado bounce turns into a goal, 2-1. Hannah, now to Marlowe at the side of the net. Patrick swings it back around for Thornton. Looking for Heatley, drops it off to Blake. He scores! Rob Blake ties it in two.
Joe Thornton just feeds it to the right man. Big shot up high, beats Craig Anderson. Joe Thornton setting up where he loves to set up, but it's a tough shot when the puck comes back to you and you're trying to one-time it. But look at the touch on the pass by Joe Thornton.
As Blake pounded that one up high past Anderson. Dan Boyle steps up in the neutral zone. Now here's a break for Matt Duchene. Across to Hayden, who scores. And Colorado has an answer just like that, and they lead 3-2.
Oh, those are...
So there's this done. Pavelski on the faceoff, and Klo's going to get to it first in the corner. Ryan Klo centering pass in the crease, and they score! Devin Setoguchi, we're tied again!
Well, a couple of shifts ago, we said Devin Setoguchi's got to get to the net on a chance. Well, he gets to the net here. Ryan Klo makes the play happen. Devin Setoguchi attacks the net from the wing position, and he gets a break as the puck skips off of Scott Hannon's stick into the net from the Rambus net cam. There's Ryan Klo, as usual, doing all the heavy lifting, and there's Devin Setoguchi.
The bok bok, and it's a turnover, and Duchene puts it right back at the net, and they score. The puck mishandled by Yevgeny Nabokov. It ends up behind him. Colorado has 4 goals on 10 shots. Broken up, Malhotra, or checked out Ortmeier, sending it in. Now flicked up the boards, takes a bounce to Ortmeier, fires it, they score!
Shift matters. Scotty Nickel makes it count. McGinn in on the forecheck. Ed Ortmeier throws the puck to the net and attacked the net off the puck. Scotty Nickel with a humongous goal.
And Scott Nickel's done that all game long. He's really been a tone setter for the Sharks in this big game too.
And those are the guys that should be setting the tone for you. The energy guys, the tough guys out there.
Stastny on the wing. And they score! And it's Stewart, and now it's 5-4.
Stewart
in, not all that deep. Klo follows it. Here's Thornton. Heatley shot. Rebound. They score! Joe Pavelski! And we're tied! A fifth time! Setoguchi, who has a goal tonight. Kaminsky on it in the corner. Now Malhotra helping out. The puck comes free to Ryan Klo. He'll fire it. They score! They score! Devin Setoguchi! And the Sharks tie the series!
Makes the pass ahead for O'Reilly, but will angle too far. Murray will put in the corner. Put, score!
They score! And the Avalanche have won! In overtime, they lead the series 2-1. What a goal! What a finish! 51 seconds in, and the Avalanche have hooked the Sharks tonight, and they lead the series 2-1.
Oh, my goodness. Mike, you talk about unexpected. The puck went into the corner. San Jose in control, but Mike, who got their stick
on the puck.
O'Reilly.
Strikes with the puck on the power play early.
Boyle. Shot. Score.
Well, a small little bit of redemption for Dan Boyle as he gets a power play goal. That team with their power play.
Now they have done so far in this series.
With a power play goal, knotted up. Both goals coming early in the period on the power play.
Well, a couple of things to watch. One, the Avalanche win the draw. And this was supposed to be a big, big asset for San Jose. But they win the draw.
Through for the defenseman, Murray. And a collapse. Shot, score! And this series is tied up in two. Pavelski gets the winner for the San Jose Sharks. And the fans here.
Shots. Pavelski, rink wide, Boyle. Pavelski fires. He scores! For a change. Back up ice. They're going to catch the Avs in a change. Here's Nickel holding the puck. Missing the net. Rebound. Helvonen. He scores! Gucci. He stays onside. Bow with the puck. Going wide to the backhand. Rebound. Scores! Logan Couture. Down to the goal line. Demers, Heatley, tipped in front, Merlo scores! Heatley, Patrick Merlo, scores his first goal of this series.
Right. Klo, who leads the Sharks with 6 points, gets it around the board. Pavelski trying to come out, he does, and scores! Joe Thornton inside the Shark zone. Cutting in front. He scores! What a play! In the corner, he comes off the boards. In front for Brandon Yip. He scores! The Avalanche ahead.
There's no secret to scoring goals in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Great work through the neutral zone by the Avs. Establish a cycle game as head.
There's Boyle now with urgency. He scores! Danny Boyle with his seconds in with Setoguchi. Pavelski shoots and scores! Bang, bang, the Sharks answer back, and it's jumps free to Setoguchi. Setoguchi to center, on goal, and in the net. That will ice it.
Well, this is just persistence, and this is what you look for. If you're Todd McClellan,
Michael Thornton staring at the gaping net. Plays it across for Doug Murray. Murray has a look and fires it in the net again, just to rub a little salt in the wounds here at the Pepsi Center. And they're heading for the exits. The city full of hope back in the playoffs after.
That we have documented for you here tonight. Here come the Hawks back. The shot and the rebound put in the net. Rene got it a rip initially, but couldn't hold it. And the Blackhawks strike first in this series at 9:43 of the second period.
And who but
missed him too in the third period. And that's deflecting into the net. J.P. Dumont just sort of flipped at it, and he's tied the game up a minute 31 into the third period.
Pete, I was following you and following the call, and I thought it was going into the corner after Niemi sort of...
All of it comes in. His shot. Big rebound given up. And the shot follow-up by Suter, stopped by Niemi. Here's Sullivan back to the net. Shovels in front, and the backhander tipped up to the glass behind the Chicago net. But it's just going after the puck, and the Blackhawks fans here a little uneasy. On Madison, now breaking in, leg one. He stopped, backhand throw, the rebound, the score! J.P. Dumont put it in, and the Predators take the lead at 10:37. They were storming the... 6 seconds remain, the Predators that far away from their first road win in their playoff history. Smithson, yes. To the empty net, scores! Jared Smithson scores the empty net goal effectively there. With 48 seconds remaining of Buffalo, 30 seconds remain. Predators lead by two. As the shot deflected around wide of the net. Cleared now by Ward, just out across the line. And stolen away by Erat. Erat skates in and slides it in. Two left.
And Teams. A shark with Teams in front. Shot missed. Teams across. Ballard scores! David Boland with the icebreaker. In the first period, the Predators were the beneficiaries of a couple of lucky breaks. Here they catch a bad break as Tutu gets called for interference. Watch the play by Jonathan Taves in front of the net. Kane gets him the puck, and Taves knows somebody's over there. He's not sure who.
Point. Here's Chicago, a 3-on-1. Kane with sharp. Kane scores!
Leguan's been in the league long enough to know that you have the puck on the sidewall. It's got to go back behind the net.
David Leguan into the slot. He had the save. Rebound scores. Joel Ward.
For hard work, and it's Joel Ward who gets to the front of the net. Leguan makes a nifty play behind the net. He's got his head up, and he finds Sullivan in the high slot. Bufflin gets caught.
Hossa and Versteeg. And here's Hossa across in front of the net. Scores! And the Hawks don't waste any time as Thomas Kopetsky has tied it with a power play goal.
Here's a reason why the Predators don't kill penalties very well. Wait, that early power play goal against.
Now Sullivan, he's got leg one with him. He front leg one, scores! Nashville has its second lead of the night.
Steve Sullivan poached this play. He read the play and he got out. Predators had killed off two in a row after that early power play goal against.
Now Sullivan, he's got leg one with him. He front leg one, scores! this year for Erat. Try to put this one away. Erat against Niemi scores.
Predators net, and the Predators have been keeping rebounds and keeping that area clear because the forwards have come back to help the defensemen. I know you love that, Crispy.
And in the interim, the Blackhawks tally on the power play with Francis Bouillon in the box to take a 1-0 lead. Very critical for Chicago. In now the right wing side, Hossa. Picks up, diving across, and now Hossa got the shot, and the rebound put in the net as Klein went down onto the ice trying to block the play. And the Blackhawks take a 2-0 lead at 12:55 of the second.
And the Blackhawks convert a nothing.
Campbell back in the lineup on D tonight for Chicago. Here's Sharp breaking in. He scores! Patrick Sharp with a move across from left to right in the high slot. And he puts the Blackhawks up 3-0 at 16:17 of the second period.
Able to come up with that and flip one that careened across and is read and held there by Legwand. He scores! Legwand! And it's 1-0.
And so all off aggressive forecheck by the Nashville Predators. They hem Chicago in, and then David Legwand there.
Taken on by Chris Versteeg.
Notara at 105.4. Drive, and that blocked right back by Jalmerson. And cleared back down and racing back for it. Kopansky moving on in. He scores!
Well, as a player sitting in a penalty box, you dream about an opportunity that once you come out of the penalty box, you're going to get a breakaway, and the rolling puck, Kopansky beats it. He beats the Pocheck of Pecorine.
Lost to the Predators, carried ahead by Legwand. Moving up is Ward, breaking to the net. He got it to it. He scores! A shorthanded goal by Ward.
Oh, Edzo, what a bad play by Patrick Kane to start this odd man rush for the Chicago Blackhawks. He's going to feel a ton of shame on this.
Enforced by Ryan Mackey's overtime goal in Milwaukee last night. Puck came to the back and is held there, thrown to the side of the net for a feed. Score! It is a goal that's scored by Martin Erat, and this game is tied. Just the ninth shot on goal in the game, but the third goal for Nashville.
What patience by Denis Grebishkov at the point.
Arnett plays on to Erat, set it back up, and it's swept across by Klein. Dealt back to Erat. He scores! Erat has broken the tie with 8:21 to go in the third.
And Enzo, the Chicago Blackhawks had two center icemen on the ice, John Madden and David Bowling. So they were protected in terms of having somebody kicked out, but the Nashville Predators do a great job getting puck possession, and now they have a one-goal lead.
And it's that man, Denis Grebishkov. Watch the patience again. Hold, and then look for the passing lane.
Suter slugged it right back in again. 33 to go. Joel Ward boomed into Keith, and the puck finally is taken on now by Taves. Taves gaining the zone. Watched there tightly by the defense of Weber. Fed one on across, and a shot deflected off the pipe. And it careened high to be taken to the outside by Sharp. Net empty. Extra attacker. Shot by Tedrio. Score!
I can't believe Martin Erat has whips this puck blindly in the offensive zone into the slot with nobody there. This is a major turning point.
But not out. Sharp in the right half boards. To Seabrook, to Taze, right circle, shoot, save, rebound, score! Patrick Kane! A short-handed goal for Patrick Kane! His first of the Stanley Cup playoffs in his career! And he ties the score at four! And once again, the UC is up for grabs! And behind with it for the Blackhawks. Galloping off the last bit of time, they've killed off the penalty. Bolin back, Sopel and drives, skipped in front, score! Side of the net, this is up the near boards. Bolin pokes it past the defenseman. Grabis got the center ace of Sopel over the Predator line, right wing. Sopel now beside the net, took it in behind. Came out to the left circle. Sopel now drops it to Jalmerson on the left half boards. Hawks come to full strength. Hosa's out of the box. Jalmerson put it in behind the net to Bolin. To Sopel right point. Hammers a shot. Here's Hosa. The rebound scores!
Hawks win! Hawks win! Marian Hosa's first Blackhawk playoff goal! It's a game winner in overtime! Hawks beat the Predators 5-4! Listen to this crowd!
Back to Keith. Keith scores! Duncan Keith, his first of the series!
Duncan Keith, who is among the three finalists for the Norris Trophy, has had a pretty miserable series.
Nolson behind the net, and the former first rounder centers it, back it comes, Shea Weber scores!
They're not going to go without a fight. One of the things that the Predators need this. This is the most incredible thing.
Pekka Rinne has just been beaten from out at center ice. And another defenseman has a goal on this one. Pekka Rinne can't believe.
Oh, this is the most incredible thing. Watch the faceoff win back to Brent Seabrook. He shoots it. It hits the Chicago player in the foot. That's good.
In the series to win game five on his 17th shot. Put it in front. It's loose. Oh, it's in. Patrick Sharp. And 3-1 Hawks. Sharp continued the battle. This series, Nashville's had a power play for over 40 minutes. Well, the goal, Weber a shot. Loose it from there it is. Jason Arden. Predators have their first power play goal of the series, and it couldn't have come at a better time. Scoring here in Nashville, Dumont back, J.P. Dumont dropped it off, and got it back from Erat, couldn't control it. Erat to the point, Hamhuis drive, scores!
First period, Danny Hamhuis' shot from the point goes through traffic.
The Predator has played in every Nashville playoff game. This is 28th, has his second playoff goal. Big shot, rebound, scores! Jonathan Taves! And they can't get out of the period, Ray. 4-3 Hawks.
Chris, I just finished saying what they want, a face-off win.
And Hossa is hooked, and there's going to be a penalty. Here's Madden down the ice, an empty net, and a series clincher for John Madden. And the Hawks will face Vancouver in round two.
net. Here's Kopitar with a little room. Side of the net. Hanzus, Stoll, shoots, scores! Jarrett Stoll on the power play, 54 seconds into the second period, and Los Angeles strikes first in the series.
You got a real sense.
Fellow on the other side, Pavel Dimitra. Sammy Salo loads up, fires, quick to save, rebound, Samuelson scores! Samuelson ties the game.
Oh, it's so important to get the help off the draw, and that's exactly what Samuelson did. But watch Daniel Sedin. Good positioning in front, and he actually kicks this puck up.
Corner gave the puck away. Daniel Sedin with a little back pass to his brother Henrik. Daniel heads for the net, takes the pass, scores! Great goal! Little Sedin magic in Vancouver. The Canucks have the lead. Oh, it's in some trouble. Bailed out by Dustin Brown, who held the puck in. He's got Frolov deep. Gives him the puck. Modine scores! Quick pass from Frolov to Modine. Los Angeles has tied the game, and they still have 3 minutes with which to work on the power play.
And, Jim, this is Dustin Brown's goal. Modine gets the goal, but it's Brown.
Back pass. Erhoff decides to hang on. Dimitra's in the slot. The pass for Henrik was blocked. Erhoff again. Henrik Sedin. Dimitra's in front. Henrik in front. Samuelson scores!
Avoid the contact.
Bernier trying to get open. Kessler. Edler's shot is just wide of the net. Christian Erhoff. Wellwood. Kessler stopped by Quick. Rebound. Bernier scores. Got a little hit in on Ryan Kessler, but he got the puck out to center. Samuelson, Erhoff heads for the net. He scores! Samuelson! The hero of game one, Michael Samuelson, hits the line. Dustin Brown, nobody's in front right now. Johnson, backdoor play, stopped by Luongo. Rebound, shoveled in front. Modine scores! Finally, the Kings get on the board. Kopitar, Salo stumbled. It's a 3-on-1. Kopitar, they score! Wayne Simmons gets the goal. And the Kings tie it up on a 3-on-1. Shortly after they got the first goal, and it's a brand new game.
And Jim, exactly what I was talking about, offensive-minded players in front of the net, whether it's your own net or the offensive net, hunt the puck.
And fakes it, Doughty, Kopitar, great block by Kessler. Kopitar scores! Andre Kopitar, Los Angeles Kings win tonight 3-2. A power play goal ties this series 1-1.
And Ryan Kessler can barely get off the ice. And that's a big moment and a big turning point in this series. 7-for-7.
Kessler out in front, backhands in front, they score! It's pumped home from right out in front. And the Canucks open the scoring at 2:09.
Well, that move pays dividends immediately.
We've got Brown parked in front. Down he looks, fires, he scores! And the Kings power play capitalizes again. They've tied this game at one. working it back around. He'll play on both the power play units. Johnson with a wrist shot, bend it off, rebound, they score! Kansas fires it home as Luongo blockered it right to him. And the Kings power play strikes again for a 2-1 lead.
They have the...
In front, Hanzu shooting and a save by Luongo.
And that was easily set up. Three passes and they get that chance.
Here's the try by Downey, a save, they score! Hanzus and Smith both around the net. Too much traffic for Luongo. And the Kings are 3 of 3 on the power play. Two of the best opportunities for Vancouver here in the second.
Right.
Big hit by Rome on Halpern. Wellwood. Holmley stick handles out of a tight spot. Canucks have found themselves in plenty of those. They score! Richardson took the puck away and scores. 4-1 LA.
Lane Vigneault must be thinking to himself, we need some kind of a pseudo timeout right now. They're going to get a TV timeout in about a half a minute. They're going to get another
take penalties.
Not that they were dumb penalties in the game tonight, but they can't kill them.
Samuelson finds the top corner there, past the glove of Quick, and Michael Samuelson's fourth goal of the series has brought the Canucks back to within a couple, 4-2.
Catching hand once it was stepped on. He said he thought it was his blocking hand, and that was the word on the bench, so no.
Now the Canucks come back and score as Burrows threw the puck in the goal mouth, and Daniel Sedin was in there, and the puck deflects in. It's a one-goal game with 16:54 to go in the third.
Well, and get it out. They get a change in.
Re-entry, Smith fires it, score! It's deflected in, floating over Raycroft, and the Kings are back in front by two.
Well, the Canucks have worked hard to try to get fresh legs on. This is the shot you want to give up, but it's a knuckler. After it hit Erhoff, I think it was going, you could tell by the way Raycroft tried to deal with it.
Hoping to reach Johnson, he does. Frolov with it. Odin is in the middle. Here's Brown trying to go forehand, and the puck still loose, backhand. They score! Doughty crashed the party in front and jammed it through, a mass of humanity. And the Kings open the scoring. Wellwood gets it back to Wendler. Sends it across. Here's a shot. Erhoff scores! He drives it home through a screen in front. And the Canucks break through in the power play. They've tied the game at one.
Well, the fleet-footed German was the guy who wheeled the puck.
Odin. They score! Fired home by Brown off the Odin pass. And BX's penalty cost the Canucks. The Kings again with a man advantage have a 2-1 lead. Teams want to change. 2-on-1 Canucks. Here's Dimitra coming in. Shooting, he scores! Pavel Dimitra registers his first goal of the series. And he's tied this game up at 2.
Well, they stopped the bleeding with the penalty kill, and then they cauterize it with this.
Penalty upcoming to Vancouver. O'Donnell fires. He sails it high over the net. But the Kings hang on with a fifth skater. Oh, they score! Deflected in front by Kopitar. LA back in front, 3-2.
A dinged up Andre Kopitar.
Bryan looks, feeds it back to Daniel Sedin. Redirected, they score! Michael Samuelson from well out on the redirection has tied the game at 3.
This is the play that on his side.
Salo across for Bieksa. The off-balance shot was tipped wide, kept alive though. Henrik Sedin to Salo, he scores! Firing at home, top corner, and Vancouver for the first time in this game leads 4-3.
The thing about Henrik Sedin is that he's able to process the...
Johnson angles it off the boards, playing in front, they score! Wayne Simmons! Off the relay, the bank shot for the point by Johnson, and Simmons bats it in to tie it at 4.
This is one high forehand play by a young defenseman. It comes back to the point. Good board work by this line to come up with the puck. Watch though, as Johnson comes out, instead of trying to rip it into Kessler's shin pads.
Henrik Sedin cuts it, goes forehand, he scores! Henrik Sedin, a tremendous move! He's given Vancouver the lead once again with 2:52 to go in the third period. 22 seconds remaining. Dowdy fires up the middle, it's picked off. Kessler shooting, scores! Into the empty net, he'll seal it for Vancouver. The Canucks will even the series. They lead 6-4 with 16.1 to play.
South Vancouver's on a short, very short power play. Alex Edler, DePavel, Dimitra, and Fred Wallwood missed the net. Another shot, they score. Steve Bernier, Vancouver's on the board. Daniel Sedin left the puck. It's gobbled up by Hanzu. Centering pass, he scores! Off Luongo and into the net. And the Kings have tied it on a bank shot.
Well, it's a turnover, and it's the Sedins on the...
Kessler for Alexander Edler. And the puck got away from him, but the Canucks get it back. They score! That looked like a broken play, but the Canucks get it to the back of the net, and it's a 2-1 Vancouver lead.
Well, it was Ryan Kessler who took over for Rippon that made the play, getting in on the fourth.
In the period, LA's fourth line has iced the puck and invited the Sedins on. Let's see if Henrik can win another draw and control the puck, and he does. Samuelson, Daniel, wrap around, he shoots, he scores! Shot and a rebound, and he got his own, and for a goal to keep Los Angeles from getting close again. Henrik, Daniels coming up late with it, takes the drop pass to Samuelson. Henrik, back to Samuelson, he shoots, he scores! What a laser beam of a shot. And it's going to chase Jonathan Quick with Vancouver leading 4-1.
Michael Samuelson wanted to shoot early, and he surprised Henrik Sedin with a pass back.
Frolov tried to tip through to Brown, broken up there by Andrew Alberts. Jones in the middle of the ice. Bieksa read that. Up he goes to the front of the net. Dimitra shot, he scores!
His team's not going to have the kind of comeback he was looking for. Jones up the middle, a quick turnover, and this is one that Erisberg would just...
5-1. Driving to the net is Matt Green. The puck's on the goal line, and it's been knocked into the net. Green got it started. I'm not sure if he'll get the goal.
Freddie Modine right on the doorstep.
Samuelson. Salah. And Michael Samuelson moves in, takes the shot, scores! Wow! Talk about a hot hand in the playoffs. Michael Samuelson has 7, and that was another laser beam.
And it's just a quick release. Lead, and you have a chance to lead a series.
And Samuelson's got 7. Now Bernier's got another, and Vancouver leads 7-2.
halfway through the third period, it's a runaway. And you wonder for
opportunities they've had.
Roloff going to muscle his way to the net against Henrik Sedin, and the referee scores! He opens the scoring at 10-08. Green holding off Bernier, helped out by O'Donnell, but Edler loads up, fires, they score! Bernier out in front may have tipped it as he was right on top of Quick. And the Canucks click on the power play to tie the game at one.
I have to think.
Kopitar fakes the shot, goes to Smith. Ball now, Brown swings and misses at it. It's controlled down. Kopitar waits, beating it down. He fires and scores! As the penalty ended, Drew Doughty drives it home. It's 2-1 LA.
We're going berserk here at Staples Center. This is a wild sequence in and around the Vancouver.
Matched up there with Daniel Sedin, wedging him against the boards. Daniel escapes to the block. Here's Bieksa firing. He scores! Kevin Bieksa slipped it through Quick, and he's tied the game early here in the third.
Well, remember,
Hucks want to close out the series tonight. Here's a try by Samuelson, breaking his stick. The shot, they score! Daniel Sedin picked up the puck and fires it home with 2:03 to play here in the third. Doughty closing in, swings wide, fires across, and it's off the stick of Stoll. Canucks busted out 3-on-1 toward an empty net. It's Burrows shooting, scores! Alex Burrows makes it 4-2 with 1:07 to play. Scoring throughout the lineup with guys stepping up, as Darryl Ray pointed out, with the injuries to Franzen. They score! Holmstrom with a shot by the glove of Rizgalov. And the first goal of the series is Handel fakes, now shoots, he scores! And a power play that was 28th in the league in the regular season produces seconds into its first postseason opportunity. The game's tied at one.
Well, the big strength, you got to come up with the puck
on. Hanging on to it, getting your chances. The Wings doing it again. They score! The shot for the point by Lidstrom gets through to the back of the net, and the Wings connect with a man advantage for a 2-1 lead.
This is like Red Wing croquet on this one.
Fires, and it's deflected by Lombardi over the net. Doan recovers the puck for Volsky. As Lombardi broke his stick on that tip, drops the stick, the pass back, they score! Fired home by Volsky, and the game is tied at two.
Well, Detroit's penalty killing.
Last 15 games where he went 13-0-2 entering the postseason. They score! Derek Morris fires it past Howard, and the Coyotes have their first lead.
Well, we're seeing an exclamation point on this high-scoring Coyote defense. This is a clean rip away from Zetterberg, and boom!
Brad Stewart, who topped 200 hits on the season. Hanzel with a big reach, gets it on goal to save. They score! It's popped in on the rebound as Yandel follows up, and the Coyotes open the scoring in game number two. Seconds remaining on the penalty. Here's Philpola out in front. They score! Henrik Zetterberg converts off the pass. The Red Wings on the power play have tied it at one.
What a play.
Cronwell had it taken away. Tapped on goal, they score! Holsky chops it in. Phoenix comes right back and leads 2-1.
Well,
this
for the young defenseman DePisto, young in terms of NHL experience. They score! It's tapped in front by Datsyuk. Somehow he was able to work it through Adrian Acoin and by Brizgalov to tie the game at two.
This is one, another example of how when you're defense.
Ahead for the captain, Shane Doan. Back to Lombardi, get behind the defense. He scores! What a goal by Matthew Lombardi! And once again, the Coyotes answered quickly. They lead 3-2. Bertuzzi is rocked by Jovanovski. However, at the other end, they score! Backhanded home by Valtteri Filppula. And the wide open scoring at both ends continues. We're now tied at three.
Man, oh man!
Right in the face of Yandel. They continue on.
It's stolen. Abdicator scores! Justin Abdicator has given Detroit a 4-3 lead.
Well, one of the county defend
for Fiddler speeding in with Doan. He scores! We're tied up at four.
What a pass. This all started, though, with some layers and a lot of compete
in the second period of this game, but at crucial moments, key faceoffs, the Coyotes have done a great job. They score! Zetterberg bats on the rebound, and the Wings have the lead with 6:06 to play in the third. Feed it back to Brad Stewart, winding and shooting, missed the net. Filppula picks it up. 7 seconds to go on the penalty. The shot, they score! Bertuzzi screening Brizgalov in front, and the shot eludes Brizgalov to make it 6-4 Red Wings late in the power play chance.
This has been one entertaining hockey game. Holy.
19 minutes to one back home, an empty net for Zetterberg. Hat-trick.
Curly fries.
Hat-trick and curly fries, yes indeed. Henrik Zetterberg. One in the regular season, now one in the playoffs for Henrik. And it's a 7-4 game with the empty netter and a three-goal night.
How unlikely is that? 7-4. Wow.
You know, when I read that curly fries mention earlier, I wasn't convinced it could happen.
No, not in the first period.
Played with other teams at some time, including Pruka, whose shot was off Jimmy Howard. Another try was off Howard. Wraparound attempt, loose in the crease. Another try. They score! Peeling his way in with Sammy Lepisto. And it's a 1-0 game, 29 seconds in.
I mean, they're not attacking at all. You give players with this much talent, time and space, they're going to make you pay.
There's a shot by Filppula. He scores!
Shoots. for Francis. Fights off Yandel. Plays it back for Lidstrom. Hard pass to Francis. Sings it across. Scores! Zone. Bertuzzi gets there first. This is as loud as we've heard this building for a first round series in a long time. Zone gets there! Loud it out!
His fourth line out of that icing, and they're all over him.
Miller the wraparound. They score! Abdelkader in the goal mouth. Miller on the wraparound. That line connects for the Wings for the game-opening goal.
There it is again. The icing play now is such.
The point guiding it for a tip goal. They score! It's hooked home by Ed Jovanovski from in front of the net to tie it.
Well, Jimmy Howard's got a beef.
But controlled by the Wings from the draw. Here's Lidstrom shooting and a save by Grzegorov. They score! And the Wings move in front with under 9 minutes. Dunson centers in front. Dunson scores! He was alone in front of Grzegorov. And it's now 3-1 Detroit.
Both defensemen for the Coyotes were in the same corner. Jovanov.
He's pressured by Phil Pelham with under a minute to go. Zetterberg has got one empty netter in the series. Make it two as he scores with 55.5 to play. It's 4-1 Wings, and they're up 3-2.
I mean, there are run-of-the-mill empty net goals, and then there's that. Speed play generated out of their own zone.
Face-off win by Martin Hansel right there. They need to start getting something positive going for the Phoenix Coyotes. Maybe this will be it.
Might be. Korpikoski moving in. Score! A shorthanded goal by Lauri Korpikoski, and it is one.
Here and Nick Lidstrom played the power play together until Snyder left and Brian Rafalski came in. This is held by Snyder. Big drive! Score! A power play goal makes it 2-0 Coyotes.
Was Brad Stewart, but it came right back here for a play by Bronson that ricocheted off Jovanovski. Spiked that in front. Stewart has had it. Scores!
Job by Taylor Pyatt down low, taking up
now. Held on further for the play to be made by Proka. He scores! Peter Proka fired it, and in it went. It becomes a 4-1 Coyotes lead.
We talk about puck possession, and Peter Proka, who's standing in front of the net, and he's waiting to see what happens. His first.
It's handed across to Morris. Derek Morris laid it back, and a shot by Yandel. They score! Was at the front of the goal. Another power play goal. 3 on the day for Phoenix and 5 total.
How about Pyatt's a guy that just said before, let's get one more power play and bury him. So he gets the goal off the shot by Yandel.
From the corner, bad angle, and the arms of the referee signal that there is no goal out of all of this.
Strange angle too. We saw a goal like that in game number 3 by Henrik Zetterberg.
Maybe this will tell us.
Martin Hansel.
It has to be all the way over the line, is it?
It's tough. I believe it's in though, Doc and Edzo.
And the verdict from Tim Peel.
After further review, it has been determined that the puck crossed the line, therefore we have a good goal.
right, so now it's a
95% is awesome.
Lidstrom closing in, waits patiently, centers now. Datsyuk fires, he scores! Pavel Datsyuk got the puck to land flat. He fired.
Took it on the backhand, and he pulled that baby out of the toolbox.
Never seen him show nerves at any time in his career. They score on the faceoff. Phoenix gets on the board. It's a 2-1 hockey game.
Well, this was going on earlier.
Italy, Lidstrom across to Zetterberg. Takes a look, goes backhand, sends it in front to Flex. Lidstrom shoots, he scores! The Wings just came. We mentioned doesn't have one in the series. Closing in here. Penalty's over. Schneider missed the pass. Stewart trying to get to the puck. He does. He cuts it, and Brizgalov, he shoots. Score! Off Brizgalov and in. Brad Stewart on the breakaway makes it 4-1. With
watching guys like Dominic Hasek and Chris Osgood, that he shouldn't let things get to him, and he stopped stressing out.
And the Wings have added more support for Jimmy Howard. As driving to the goal to put home the rebound was Todd Bertuzzi, his first goal of the series, and it's now 5-1 Detroit. The fan throwing a bottle on the ice. Here's Rafalski faking the shot across to Lidstrom. Shooting! He scores! He sneaks a top corner just inside the crossbar of the goalpost, and it's 6-1 Detroit with a second half of the double minor awaiting them.
How good is